The DNR says that they are shifting their strategy and getting more aggressive in their efforts to prevent the spread of aquatic invasive species, especially zebra mussels. So tonight, Tim Cherno is live at Lake Minnetonka with an explanation for us. Tim?
Well, Leah, you can see two of those activities behind me, inspecting boats that want to go on the lake on this side and over on the other side, cleaning boats that come off the lake. Now, Lake Minnetonka already has zebra mussels, and the temptation would be to just write it off and move on to lakes that don't and protect them. Well, the DNR is employing a two-fisted strategy. One, keeping zebra mussels out of lakes that don't have them, but also preventing zebra mussels from getting out of lakes that do. So the fight goes from pushing this way and pushing that way.
Zebra mussels can attach.
The DNR brought a teaching aid to make their point about zebra mussels. Talk about putting the gross in grocery. It may not look like it now, but the unofficial start of summer and the boating season is just days away. And the DNR shared their invasive species battle plan.
We've all got the privilege of using these lakes, and we've got a personal responsibility as well.
Clean your boat and trailer. Pull the drain plug and leave it out during transport. Drain water from bait buckets and live wells and dispose of unwanted live bait.
The laws are fairly basic, fairly simple.
The focus this year, infested lakes. Why?
We still have more lakes that do not have zebra mussel in them than those that do, and that's another reason why we're focusing on the ones that do have them in it, because it's a smaller number.
The DNR will have 150 inspectors at high-use public ramps around the state. And this summer, look for 23 high-pressure hot water decontamination stations.
Over the last 2 years, we have ramped up both enforcement and inspection.
Last year, issuing more than 1,500 warnings and nearly 1,000 citations.
Speaking from my stance, if you pull into the boat launch with zebra mussels attached to your watercraft and you haven't been warned before, don't expect a warning from me.
That's hardball. Now, the DNR is not alone in this fight. They're teaming up with local governments and also Three Rivers Park District as far as fines for transporting zebra mussels up to $1,000 in Spring Park. Tim Cherno.